booted back up in Fusion 14's Fedora Remix, and I'm going to go to, I use my arrow keys to, you know, be able to select different things. I'm going to hit basic video and see if that works. I'm going to hit escape to get it, or you can hit it, I think you can hit any key, but I always hit escape. It's what I'm used to from almost many things, so I'll just kind of try to hold here and while it boots up, see what kind of feedback we get in the terminal window here. Welcome to Fusion Linux. That's last time I was, when I was watching it, everything said okay. I didn't see any errors. This time it's, well, I set the basic video, and so now the, that's a good sign now that the text is bigger and more readable. That, well, usually that, if that's happening, then usually it'll probably work when it boots up. My phone's in my way, I can't see the bottom right of the screen, but I can look at the phone and see it's all green. Okay, green, okay is green. It's usually red when there's a problem. Okay, there's a little graphic icon. And it's booted up a little faster. So far, so good. I think we saw that boot screen a while ago. Oh yeah, we did. That's right. So we have to get past this to be home free, see if we're home free. We'll see here in a minute. I don't know if this Fusion is still being developed. It may not be. I never did. I think I downloaded the 15 and then that was as far as I went with it. I quit following it after that. Fedora 14 is my favorite version of Fedora ever. It had the most working, it was very stable, most working apps. There's so many thousands of apps to choose from. There's a lot of them that just aren't being developed anymore for Fedora. And so I haven't been able to let go of my old Fedora system. I still have it and I use it whenever I run into a crash of Genome panel. Well, that's not real good. Oh yeah, this is Genome 2. Fedora 14 is the last year of Genome 2. So yeah, we have graphics. We have our boot screen. So let's see. What can we do here? Trying to find where my edge of my screen is. There we go. Okay, this one has a Mint. They used to call it the Mint search bar, or whatever, not search bar, but anyway, this was the Mint menu. They used to call this the Mint menu, the one that you can search in like this. Okay, there's what's in Wine. There's the Wine apps that are available. RegEdit, Wine Boot, Wine Configuration. I don't see Internet Explorer. Let's look in the Wine Configuration first. We do have a being updated. Okay, wants to install a Gecko package. Yeah, it always did that. Okay, I'll say okay, let it do it. Said it's doing it automatically. Can do it automatically. And that crash is in Genome panel. Well, as long as the thing works, okay. Oh. Control, serious problems. So it may not work. Then again, it may have just crashed because this wasn't installed yet. Or could have been crashed while it was being installed. We'll just continue on until I find out whether or not it'll work at all. I believe it would work if I remember right. But yeah, that error down there, or that crash in the genome panel, it may not stop us from, shouldn't stop us from being able to use the system at all, I don't think. There used to be quite often you'd find wine coming with a lot of the remixes, but I got away from even caring because it just wouldn't do anything anymore. Basically, all it would do is run a few old applications that were basically things that could just about things that you didn't have to install, things that you didn't that would, you know, be considered portable apps. Nowadays they like to call them portable apps. You just run from the executable file. Things that didn't have to write all kinds of files to the registry and all that stuff. It's very slow at trying to download that. There's Chromium. I don't want to open up too much stuff though and get it slowed down either. Let's see. All applications. Oh, it's still under the search of wine. It did never go away. And go to all, and then I'll just got a lot of good applications in there. It might not have Firefox on there, it might just have Chromium, which is what Chrome is built on. Yeah, it has Firefox 4, and we're at like Firefox 49. So, yeah, it has Crusader. That was one thing I liked about it. Now, I used to use this when I was trying to if I was trying to get files off of a broken system, and I could just turn this on, it would mount the drives, or I could mount them easily and then use Crusader to copy the files. It's the only, Crusader has a real good sync built into it. I'm always a lot more sure I'm getting what I'm expecting to get than using those single panel file managers. They have a different way of copying files, and sometimes they won't. They don't sync well, even though it says it's syncing. That seems to be hung up. What's this? Checking for security updates. So I don't want to update anything right now. I don't have enough room to do that. Although it doesn't look like a whole lot of stuff. 32 megabytes. I won't try to do that right now. But my downloading thing is just sitting there. Maybe it really did crash, huh? Must have. I'll close it. Okay, so it went ahead and opened up the configuration app. Yeah, I wanted to see, it says XP, different settings in there. No audio driver. Just say okay. Only thing is, wait a minute. You know what? I don't think, Wine doesn't come with Internet Explorer. If you want it, you have to install it. And it's really not all that easy to do. I mean, it doesn't just work. There, Wine. There's the what's in there. So I don't have Internet Explorer anyway. That wasn't really what I wanted, was it? Okay, I wanted to be able to run that trend, that executable file. Do you think that I could get away with installing 32 megabytes of updates? What's it updating? Adobe Flash? Kmods, multi-track audio editor. It's not updating any of the web browsers. That's the thing I was thinking. Why? If I could update the web browser. I'm gonna do it just for grins. This probably won't be make me grin though, will it? It'll probably aggravate me. I'll have more problems. I'm just gonna let it do it. It didn't say anything about Chromium, so I'm gonna open that up. Actually, I should have opened up Firefox. But goes to the Fusion web page. Since it was already put down here on the bar, I figured it was the one they'd like you to use. I see a SE Linux denial. Something's not allowed. Let's look at my update. Oh, additional confirmation. That just popped up. Something didn't work on the Fusion Linux page. Now it's installing the updates. He's dead, Jim. They used to put all those funny, I guess they still do, errors in there. But they're not funny when you keep getting them over and over when you're trying to do something. Okay, where's the, how do you get back to the main window? That update thing, it won't go, whoops. Oh, now it's wanting to know to trust RP infusion, yeah. Okay, but there's no way it says authentication for root password, but there's no, I think you can just click on authenticate. Because it doesn't have a root password set. May not be able to do it. Usually you can just click do it, authenticate, and it'll just do it. I'm gonna hit cancel on that one. It's actually may not be responding right now. Just doing nothing. Canceling is not doing anything either. Yeah, the little ball still spinning up there, down there. Depends on where you put it. It's up above my camera. Close it. Now it'll probably install some things and not others. So it's like just going to turn into an aggravation, isn't it? It's the same thing. Doesn't have to cancel either. Well, so that wasn't such a fun little whim, was it? It'll install whatever. It's only going to install security updates because it's Fedora 14. Well, it's finding the repos. How about that? Well, I don't see how it's doing that because my system, all the repos were moved to a, I guess I trust it. All my repos were moved to a another server, you know. And, all the 4.4.14 stuff, and I could never even get my app manager to. I was gonna have to manually edit the files, and then just for so much trouble, I never got around to doing it. Since I didn't use it much anymore, anyway, I had pretty much all the apps I wanted. Okay, I accidentally clicked on. Oh, look at the. FusionLinux.org is no longer there. Get this foreign website now. Well, the guy was overseas, I remember that. I got on their forums some. But, he wasn't like Chinese or anything. He was, somewhere like in the Netherlands or something. Yeah, I started. I opened a can of worms. I shouldn't have done that. It's also kind of slowing down the system. Okay, that update's what I'm talking about. All applications, that's what I wanted. Internet, Firefox, there. Okay, welcome to Firefox now. Now I'm just gonna see what I can get out of here. Free online virus scanner. Go to trend. Oh, it's been trend micro. They have one. Bitdefender. I always forget that trend micro and Bitdefender are different. I was on Trend Micro, and Bitdefender is actually the one that I had been. Couldn't go to the Fedora. Firefox 4 can't open up. I'll bring it down there where it can be seen in the camera. Firefox 4 can't open up. Page right on for Bitdefender. This is the one I was downloading. I'll just do it again, see if it runs in wine. It's not, that's actually not the one I had. And not even intended on running. House call. Yep, I remember that name now. Maybe it's not done downloading. Oh yeah, it was. It opened it up and I'll have to go to the file manager. Open containing folder. Go see if the update's still messing around down there. It's still working. When that quits, I'll be a lot better off. Okay, now. See, it even shows the Windows icon. Let's see. But it's set default to open with Archive Manager. Open with Wine Program Loader. I haven't even tried to mount the NTFS drive. There, 250 gigabyte file system. It sees it. I won't try to mount it yet. Here, let's see. Oh, okay. So far, I haven't done it yet. What's the other? Okay, I'm going to close the windows that are not being used. Well, better be careful. I'll close things I need. You already downloaded that, so I won't mess with that anymore. That's not going to be much good if it can't see it. I could always download the new version of Firefox and just run it. It'll run in Linux just straight off the. These other, I don't keep icons down here like that, like Windows does. It's like it's kind of set up like Windows, and so I keep thinking they're already open, and I click on them. Six updates available. Where's my update? Checking for updates. There's more updates. It must have finished. PLC music going. Play on Linux. That's part of Wine. It's only 13 megabytes. Yeah, I know, I'm gonna mess up again. I've sat around here installing apps before on different live systems and filled up my memory, and then I couldn't do anything. Okay, no more packages. And we got a phone on back in. Play on Linux. Looks like Play on Linux won't update. You know, I remember last time I seriously tried to use. You can. I don't care about Music Brains Picard. Let's just take out VLC 2. I'm not going to be using that right now. What's the two updates? It says two, but I've only got one selected. I think Play on Linux is one of the ones with dependencies that wouldn't work, but let's try it anyway. I've deselected everything except for Play on Linux, because that's part of Wine, and it actually does help Wine work better. Okay, so it requires Red Hat LSB, VLC requires. Okay, so there's no way Play on Linux is going to update. Now, if I'm done with playing with my updates, I think so. Okay, so, open with Wine. Let's see if it will this time. Tried it a minute ago and I didn't see anything happen. Maybe that's what my, oh, there we go. Near the internal error has prevented House Call from opening. Do you want to visit House Call website today? Nah, no point in doing that. I'm gonna delete that. Move to trash. Guess I can move it to trash and then empty the trash. Let's go look at that NTFS hard drive. If it won't mount it for me, then I'm up the creek anyway. There it is, it mounted it. Okay, so that's usually it just says need to authenticate and then you don't gotta do nothing. Maybe I shouldn't have clicked on that before. Trash. Empty trash. Since I'm running in memory, we do not need all this extra stuff. Alright, Firefox. Help. About Firefox. Oh, usually it says don't, it needs to be updated, don't you want to update it? I guess they didn't used to do that back then. Should be another way. Tools, come on. Okay, I'm gonna open up a new, I don't wanna lose my search. Just trying to go to Firefox just so I can see the download. Yeah. I don't want to see how wonderful it is. I just want to download it. Yeah, 48. Okay. Got 49 on my other system. I'll copy this to clipboard, close it. I said no to that a minute ago, didn't I? Should be in downloads. Okay, now then. Let's see if we can get a dual. Oh, I've got Crusader on here. Let's use Crusader. KRU. There it is. Crusader. Takes a long time to find out you can't even do stuff. Oh, that's updates. There's an SC Linux denial. That's something I might want to look at and see if it's stopping me from doing what I want to do. Can't write Crusader. I may not be able to run Crusader. Wine preloader, yeah, it won't. I don't know if that's it looks like Crusader's gonna run, but it won't, probably won't run in. That's all the setup stuff. I always have a certain way I like it to be. So I always do that. And I always tell it to save the settings when I move. I'm not doing it real good, but I just want to go through main stuff. Now I'm going to leave it down here. Right now, minimize it. I keep forgetting you can't see the whole screen. User bin one preloader map zero on this. Ignore delete troubleshoot. If you were trying to. Do not think you want to control the ability. If you want to allow it, it's not letting me go there though. Usually that's not. Oops, that's not what I wanted. Oh, okay, details, Oh, on the live system, you don't have root privileges. It says notify admin. How funny. I am admin. I already know. So anyway, I mean, normally you can copy and paste these commands and run them. That's what I was thinking I might do. So there you go. You're probably crippled to running things in Wine like you even want, even could. And I can't see enough of the. I gotta make that huge to see it. Can't see it with it tiny like that. I guess I'll pick this up. Saying it can't get to the directory on the right. What was I gonna try to do? Okay, we're in live user downloads. Okay, now. Yeah, home live user. That should be a good place now. I just need to unpack Firefox. And then I can run it. I'm going to set these to put the last modified at the top. And what's my little. Oops, I clicked on terminal again. Unpin. Even use the words like Microsoft does. Okay, that's actually useful. Show the desktop. Okay, I think it should have finished by now. I guess it's. Yeah, I don't see anything happening. You know, when you're doing something, it'll go behind your program. There it is, Firefox. Just wasn't quite done yet. Okay, I'll probably go back to by the alphabetical order so I can find it. Firefox. I'm going to say run. I was right-clicked and run. That's what I did. I might have to do it in the terminal. When you do that, you see what's happening that way. Instead of just, if you just run and it doesn't work, then. Of course, it's probably just taking a little while running off of this DVD. 965 megabyte free out of 5.18 gigabyte. That would be in the live system. So it didn't have all that much to work with. Now, how do you get 5.8 gigabyte and 2 gig of RAM? Well, that's magic. I don't know. I've read about how they do that sort of thing, but I do believe they use your well, there's not any Linux. See, like on this one, there's not any Linux swap partition on here, and it doesn't write to your hard drive. So I heard my camera beep. I may be getting to as big a file as it can do. I hope that the auto restart is on. It might not be. I guess these videos are getting too big and long anyway. I get involved and I just keep going and going. It's not opening up though. It might not run on Fedora 14. You know what? On my Fedora 14, I had done it like this, and I ran it for years, and it wouldn't have just set it to auto update, and it would just keep on updating, so I was up to date. But a few months ago, 6 months ago, I think it said it won't update anymore, and that the newest version wouldn't run. Yeah, I didn't think of that. Wouldn't run on Fedora 14, so. System. These boxes. Okay, hang on. I'm just gonna hold this thing for now because I can't do anything in tiny windows. Okay. What do I want? It's going to open up something. I still see recording there, so I guess maybe that noise was it restarting. Okay, so I don't have Firefox running. Oh, I wanted to see system. System. There we go. There's two system monitors. I don't know which one is which. There's one I like better than other. This is a pretty good one. Make it bigger so I can see what's going on. Okay, system monitor is using the most. This is Linux kernel 2.635, AMD dual core, available disk space 965, that's the way it sees it. Okay, so yeah, there's but there's one where you can search for apps, and so I'm going to see if I can get it running here. I'm doing my search there. So I think I started with the top one, didn't I? Okay, system monitor. Yeah, this one. Firefox. So there's no Firefox running, period. Okay. So we're going to open up. Now, I always put it up here in the top, but of course it's not. I didn't set it up my way yet. So tools, start terminal here. See, I'd already clicked over here on the right on Firefox actually. So I'll just move that over there. Now then, ./, instead of trying to type it, especially when you have a long hard to type name. In this case, it's because I'm holding a camera in my left hand. Paste Firefox. That'll run it. Error. Oh. Error. XPGUM glued error for file or live in Firefox. So it cannot open shared object file. So it's got a dependency missing. So there ain't no way you're running this. New version of Firefox. on the old system. I probably tried that before. Where is it? Firefox. So before I get this thing where it won't run, I'm gonna delete that. One good and something. Well, I don't know if it can be a good thing. It can be a bad thing. But when you delete stuff in Crusader, they're deleted. They don't go to trash. So that can be a problem. But most of the time, I'm cool with that. There's no trash on the desktop. So I guess if I go into the file system there, that's my 250 gigabyte hard drive. I could, if it'll open up. I guess I'll close Crusader, give it a little less. It's too much reading, right? I can hear that CD just spinning like crazy. Too much reading and writing going on for it to be fast. I wanted to see. So you'd have to be able to get by with your old web browser. I just wanted to make sure there wasn't anything in the trash. That's all I was trying to do. It's not responding. There we go. Trash. Yeah, it's empty. Okay, now go back to Chromium and see if we can do anything with that. Oh. Oh, it tries to go to fusionlinux.org and it's no longer there. So there's the answer to my question. No, the project's not even around. It's not around anymore because they don't have their website anymore. Kill the page. Now, let's see. I guess it'll search from the bar. I did put, that was Firefox. I put my link in the, there, free online virus scan. Someone that someone had searched for sent free online virus removal. Now that might be another way. This could be used. I mean, if you could find something that would do it. There used to be quite a few to choose from, but I only really see one that's really an online virus scanner, and that's that page that wouldn't come in. That it's Bitdefender is what it is, and I don't know why I always think that I don't think Chromium's going to work at all. I don't know why Bitdefender. I confuse Bitdefender and Trend Micro. I think it's really just because they have. I don't know why. Nah, it's not gonna work. So Chromium, this old Chromium won't work at all. Firefox 4 is the only one that'll do anything. So yeah, it's just too old. It's been a long time since I tried to use it. Back whenever, you know, you're only up in Fedora 16, 17, 18, it worked fine. Here, remembered my last search. Okay, so what I want is Bitdefender. Let's see. There, online virus scanner. Let's see if it. I bet since it's not doing anything but showing a straight HTML version of the page, there ain't no way you're going to get it to do it. This is the one I had wanted to try. Of course, the page doesn't look like that normally. So, but I'm pretty sure it wouldn't work anyway. I mean, you might be able to, if you could. I have some old Internet Explorer install files on my server, but if I wanted to boot it up and try to run them in Wine, but I really never, I only got, let's see, what did I get to run? I think I got Firefox to run, and then put in that, there was an add-on that would make it act like, oh, that's something you can do. You can make it act like Internet Explorer, and you can still run some of these little apps that are looking for Internet Explorer, but it's usually just a pain and it doesn't always work. Then there's a Microsoft Safety Scanner, which I never have tried. It'd probably be the same thing. There'll be Flash and Java on these pages, things that are both encrypted and unencrypted. It's a free download security tool. Oh. It expires 10 days after being downloaded. Okay, so yeah, it's just kind of a, it's just a portable virus scanning app. You can download it and run it. So it probably wouldn't even run. It is, does make me curious. Okay, I'll just see if it will run. Open the containing folder. I want to see if it'll run in Wine. I don't think I would let it. I would fool around with waiting on it to scan. As long as it takes. It takes 3 to 5 hours. Well, that one, Dr. Webb, I ran it all night and all day. Actually, I ran it half a day, all night, all and all of another day, and it never did finish, and I had to finally got tired of waiting on it. Yeah, I see Linux alert, so that means it ain't going to run. It's, can hit dismiss, but that won't let it happen. That just stops it from warning you. So, I can't even run Wine stuff in here. So that answers that question. If I could do it in Wine, it certainly wouldn't be in an older version, would it? In an older Fedora system. And I've looked through most of all these others I see, and they're really just, the only one I didn't really look at was Panda Online. The rest of them just look like just downloads for trialware of different antivirus solutions that you install. First month free, that's just a trial. They used to have a free one. Yeah, so no, I wouldn't fool around with none of that. I've already ran, you know, a vast boot time scan and run, I think I've run about five different rescue, Linux rescue systems with different antivirus and malware solutions on them, including running malware bytes in safe mode. And I really wanted to scan it one more time with a pretty good one to see if it would come up clean, then I'd just leave it like it is and use it. But I guess if I'm going to do that, I'm going to have to find another rescue system that I haven't used yet. Wouldn't be any sense in using one I've already used, because each one found a different bunch of Trojans malware and whatnot, and took them out. So that whole, at least if you're gonna, I guess if you really want to get serious about trying to use Wine to run a Windows application in Linux, and you better get the new Wine. What do we got? Connection manager. The battery is low. 14% remaining. Okay. Well, I'm going to stop this anyway. That's what I was getting ready to do. Plug the phone in. And, okay. This whole day has been nothing but going around in circles and running into problems. And I just haven't been feeling good today. I haven't felt good all week, really. But I shouldn't have started, I guess, so early on in my day, and I just sent myself on one goose chase after another. I was in that mode where I'm gonna get this done. I don't care, you know, if I don't feel good, if I can't think. Well, guess what? All you did was go in circles. You could have relaxed and read and watched a few YouTube videos. Okay, goodbye.